Hello, welcome to the step-by-step tutorial on the development of 3D slicer extension. My name is Sen Li. In this video, we will create a new custom extension module together, understand the file structure of your extension module, and add your extension module to the toolbar's favorite modules. To begin from scratch, let's first download the most recent version of 3D slicer. We Google 3D slicer, click download, and then choose your operating system to install. After the installation, you will see the slicer user interface like this. Now, let's create our custom extension module. We go to the module selection, find the developer tools, and then choose the extension wizard. This is where we can create and manage extensions from within Slicer. We click the button Create Extension and give the name of the extension Tutorials. Give the destination the folder address. Click OK and then change the category to Tutorials and change the contributor name and the organization. Click OK. In one extension, you can add multiple modules, just like all those examples. There are multiple modules in one extension. Now, let's add one module to the extension. Give the module name T for template, apply threshold, and click OK. Click Yes. You can find the file structure of our extension here. One CMake file to help the 3D slicer to load the extension, and one image file for the extension. I'm not sure where this image is used. Please leave me a message if you know where it is used. And here is our module folder, T apply threshold. Let's unfold this folder to check what's inside. Besides this CMake file, there is one Python file, which is the most important file we will be working on. There are two subfolders. One subfolder is called testing. It's for running unit tests of the module. We can just keep it here and no need to change it. The other folder is called resources. This is where you can change the icon of your module, or you can edit the GUI of your module. Okay, we are done with the extension wizard. So how do we boot up the extension module we just created? We need to go to the module selection again and find the category examples. T apply threshold. Remember we changed the category from examples to tutorials? This might be a small bug of 3D slicer. To fix this bug, let's go to the module we created. Click T apply threshold. Now we are in the module T apply threshold, the template module created by 3D slicer. In order to fix a small bug and replace the category from examples to tutorials, we need to edit the Python file. Click the button Edit, and the Python file will be opened by the default application. What we need to do is to change the category from examples to tutorials. After saving the Python file, we need to restart Slicer. Click the button Restart. Here we go. When we go to the module selection, the category examples is gone, and our category tutorials is on the top. That's great. We fixed the bug. Now let's add our module to the toolbar favorite modules. We go to the menu Edit. Click Application Settings, go to Modules, and our module T Apply Threshold is already added to the additional module path. What we want to do is to find our module T Apply Threshold from this module list and then drag and drop to the favorite modules. So we click the one and press button T to jump. This is our module T Apply Threshold. We drag this module to the favorite modules. Here we go. However, this icon here is a general icon that may not be distinctive. We want to change this icon image. Let's go to the module folder, resources, and icons. We remove all the existing icon image and change the name of the icon we want to replace. Now let's go back to the 3D slicer, click OK, and restart. Here we go. Now we are able to go to our module through the toolbar favorite modules. Let's make a summary for this video. In this tutorial, we created a new custom extension module, looked into the module folder and learned about the module files. We fixed the bug of the module category and added our new created module to the toolbar favorite modules with a beautiful icon. That's it. If you have any questions or comments, please feel free to leave me a message and I will respond as fast as possible. I will see you in the next video. Thank you.